Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I will give a tutorial on how to install macOS Monterey on a MacBook Pro 2012 or unsupported Mac. In this tutorial, I installed macOS Monterey on a 2012 MacBook Pro using Opencore Legacy Patcher 0.4.2. As is known, MacBook Pro 2012 is no longer supported by Apple with the latest OS. So need a little tweaking via Opencore Legacy Patcher. Opencore Legacy Patcher download link can be seen in the description. Before starting, don't forget to subscribe to this channel. First, plug the USB flash drive into the MacBook's USB port. Now there are results of mounting the USB flash drive on the desktop. Now click Launchpad, click Other then click Disk Utility. In the Disk Utility window click View and then click Show All Devices. On the left pane, click on the USB flash drive, and in the right pane click the Erase button. On Scheme select GUID Partition Map. On Format select macOS Extended Journaled. On Name leave the default or can be with another name. Then click the Erase button. Wait for the erase process to finish. After the erase process is complete, click the Done button. Then close the Disk Utility window. Now open your favorite browser. Then go to google.com. In the Google search box, type Opencore Legacy Patcher. Then hit enter. On the search results page, click on the .nes/opencore-legacy-patcher GitHub link. Under releases click latest. Scroll down to assets. Under assets there are several downloadable file options. There are OpenCore files which are GUI based. And other terminal based OpenCore files. Because this tutorial uses a GUI based OpenCore then click the OpenCore Patcher GUI offline file. Wait for the download process of Opencore Legacy Patcher 0.4.2 to finish. After the download process for Opencore Legacy Patcher 0.4.2 is complete, click the Show in Finder icon. I drag the Opencore Patcher file to the desktop, so it's easy to find. Right-click on the Opencore Patcher file and then click Open. In the pop-up window that show up click the Open button. Okay, the main Opencore Legacy Patcher window has been shown up. In the main window of Opencore Legacy Patcher, there are several menu options. First menu is Build and Install Opencore. In this menu, I can build and install Opencore to SSD or USB flash drive. The second menu is Post Install Root Patch. This menu will show up after you finish upgrading or installing macOS Monterey. The third menu is Create macOS Installer. This menu has the option to download macOS or create a bootable installer for macOS. The fourth menu is Settings. In this menu you can configure according to your MacBook or you can also leave the default configuration. The fifth menu is Help. In this menu you can find the user manual of Opencore Legacy Patcher. Because I don't have macOS Monterey, so I choose the Create macOS Installer menu. In this menu there are three options. First, the Download macOS Installer menu. The second menu if you have downloaded the macOS Installer. And the third menu is back to the main menu. Because I don't have macOS Monterey, so I choose the Create macOS Installer menu. Wait for the macOS catalog download process to complete. The macOS catalog download process is complete and many macOS download options appear. Because I want to install macOS Monterey, so I choose the latest macOS Monterey, namely macOS Monterey 12.2.1. Now wait for the download process for macOS Monterey 12.2.1 to complete. In the pop-up window that appears, enter the Mac admin password. Then click the OK button. OK, the download process for macOS Monterey 12.2.1 is complete. To create a USB macOS Monterey, click the Flash Installer menu. Then click Install macOS Monterey 12.2. Then click the USB flash drive that will be formatted. In the pop-up window that appears, enter the Mac admin password. Then click the OK button. Then wait for the macOS installer USB creation process to complete. An indication that if the macOS installer USB creation is complete, a success pop-up window will appear. Then click the OK button. Now click on Return to Main Menu button. On the main menu window, click on Build and Install Opencore. Now click on the Build Opencore menu. Then click the Install Opencore menu. In the Install Opencore window, click on USB flash drive. Then click on EFI USB flash drive. In the pop-up window that appears, enter the Mac admin password. Then click the OK button. The process of installing Opencore to a USB flash drive is on progress. Wait for this process to complete. The process of installing Opencore to a USB flash drive is complete. Now click on Return to Main Menu button. Now back to the main menu window. Then close the Opencore Legacy Patcher window. Now, restart the MacBook. Once the screen turns gray, immediately press the Options key and hold the Option key until the boot options show up. Now the boot options have appeared. Next, select the EFI boot and then hit Enter. Now select Install macOS Monterey. And then hit Enter. Wait for the loading process to finish. Okay, the loading process is complete and enter the recovery window. Now click Install macOS Monterey. Then click the Continue button. Then click the Continue button again. Click Agree and click Agree again. Now select the SSD to which macOS Monterey will install. Then click the Continue button. Now wait for the download process for macOS Monterey 12.2.1 to complete. The macOS Monterey installation process is complete. In the accessibility window, click the Not Now button. In the analytics window, click the Continue button. If there is a system extension blocked pop-up window, then click Open Security Preferences. In the Security and Privacy window, click the lock icon in the lower left corner. In the pop-up window that appears, enter the Mac admin password. Then click the Unlock button. Now click the Allow button. In the pop-up window that appears, click the Not Now button. Now close the Security and Privacy window. The next step, right click on Opencore Patcher. Then click Open. The main menu of Opencore Legacy Patcher has appeared. In this step, I need to root patch on the system. But before doing root patch, first I need to check the graphics display. Click the Apple logo, then click About This Mac. As seen in the graphics section, the graphics display is only 3 megabytes, so I need root patch for graphics display to be detected. Now click the Post Install Root Patch menu. As you can see, there is a patch for Intel Ivy Bridge graphics. So that later the graphics display will no longer be 3 megabytes. Now click the Start Root Patching menu. In the Relaunch as Root pop-up window, click the Yes button. In the pop-up window that appears, enter the Mac admin password. Then click the OK button. After Relaunch as Root, click again on the Post Install Root Patch menu. Now click the Start Root Patching menu. Wait until the patching process is complete. Okay, the patching process is complete. The patching process is complete. There will be a notification that says patching complete. The MacBook needs to be restarted for the patch to take effect, but before restart, Opencore need to be installed to SSD. Now click on Return to Main Menu button. Now I need to install Opencore to SSD, so that when booting it doesn't need a USB flash drive anymore. On the main menu window, click on Build and Install Opencore. Now click on the Build Opencore menu. Then click the Install Opencore menu. Now click or select SSD. Then click the EFI SSD menu. Now click on Return to Main Menu button. Then close the Opencore Legacy Patcher window. Next, eject the USB flash drive by right-clicking the USB flash drive and selecting Eject. Now unplug the USB flash drive. Now, restart the MacBook. Now click the Apple logo and click About This Mac. As you can see, graphics display has been detected as Intel HD Graphics 4000, so the graphical display is QECI. So there will be no lag for graphic display. So that's it. If this video is useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, just comment down below. Thanks for watching and have a great day ahead. See you in the next video.